Hi, I'm Steggy from Elgato, and this is HD60X. HD60X is the latest to join our game capture line of products. Building off the iconic HD60 platform, HD60X is an external USB 3.0 capture card that can capture up to 1080p 60 HDR and can pass through up to 4K 60 HDR or 1440p 120 SDR footage. And this is our first capture card to feature VRR pass-through, making HD60X the perfect companion to your next-gen console streaming or recording. In this video, we're going to cover everything you need to know about HD60X, how it compares with the rest of our lineup of capture cards, and discuss which capture card might be best for you. First, let's talk about the design. HD60X features a brand new design that looks as good as the content you're going to create with it. The USB and HDMI ports are now located on the rear side, allowing you to have your capture card on your desktop or TV stand, while keeping your cable management nice and tidy. And HD60X features a 3.5mm port on the front side, so you can easily plug in Chatlink Pro for when you're capturing PS5 or Nintendo Switch gameplay, so you're able to capture all of the audio for your recordings or live streams. Now, if you don't know what I was just talking about right there, we've linked a video in the description panel down below that explains everything you need to know about Chatlink Pro and why you want to use it for PS5 and Nintendo Switch capture, so be sure to check it out. Now, when discussing the capturing capabilities of HD60X, it can best be described as a successor and upgrade to HD60S+. So like its predecessor, HD60X is an external USB 3.0 capture card that's equipped with a USB-C port and can create amazing quality content on your Windows or Mac machine. And all with instant game view, meaning you have ultra-low latency in your recording or streaming software, which makes things a whole lot easier and more plug-and-play since you don't have to worry about syncing your sources together. Everything just works. But HD60X brings a lot of new things to the table. Let's start with what you can capture. With HD60X, you're able to capture up to 1440p 60 SDR, 1080p 60 HDR, or 4K 30 HDR footage while passing through up to a 4K 60 HDR signal. And for more on pass-through, we're excited to announce that HD60X supports high refresh rate pass-through of resolutions up to 1080p 240fps or 1440p 120fps. So, not only can you enjoy your games in the amazing detail that 4K 60 HDR brings when you're creating content for streaming or VOD, but now you can immerse yourself in the fast-paced action with high refresh rate pass-through. Now, to note, similar to HD60S Plus and 4K 60 Pro Mark II, capturing HDR content with HD60X requires 4K capture utility, which means you'll need Windows if you want to capture HDR. And like 4K 60 Pro and HD60S Plus, HD60X features onboard SDR tone mapping. So if you're using different apps like OBS on Windows, or if you're using an app on Mac, HD60X will allow you to play your game in HDR and convert the signal to SDR for your viewers on Twitch, YouTube, etc. Now, you can even combine 4K capture utility and OBS using our StreamLink feature. So you can record HDR content using 4KCU for YouTube while streaming SDR for Twitch, YouTube, Facebook Gaming, etc. Now, if you're not sure what StreamLink is, be sure to check out our 4K capture utility overview video where we talk about all of its great features that you can utilize for your content creation needs. But let's get back to the hardware. So with HD60X, you can pass through up to 1440p 120fps or up to 1080p 240fps gameplay while you're capturing, which lets you take advantage of the capabilities that the newest generation of consoles have to offer. And what's more is, HD60X is our first capture card ever to support variable refresh rate, or VRR. Now, VRR is a feature that dynamically syncs your display's refresh rate to the output of your source. In other words, it syncs your display up with your console or PC. And what this does is, it eliminates screen tearing or video jitter when your console or PC isn't hitting its target FPS. In other words, if you're in a really graphical intense scene in your game and your FPS starts to drop, you aren't going to have any artifacting or tearing in your pass-through footage when you're playing, so it's not going to look like this. Now, VRR will be active between 48fps and 120fps with HD60X. So if your frame fluctuation stays within these bounds, you'll be covered by VRR. Now, for your reference, HD60X supports both HDMI 4 and VRR, as well as AMD FreeSync, so you'll need a monitor that supports either one of those in order to use this feature. You'll also need a VRR-capable source, such as Xbox Series X or S. so this feature isn't available on older systems like PS4, for example. Now, in addition to supporting new pass-through resolutions and frame rates, HD60X's scaling abilities are significantly improved as well. If you want a game in 1440p 120fps, HD60X will scale this down to 1440p 60fps. So you not only have the advantages of high resolution with high frame rate, but your VODs or live streams will have more detail thanks to the 1440p 60 capture. Now, if you want the maximum frames and opt for 1080p so you can get that 240fps, HD60X can scale this down up to 1080p 120fps. Now, this can be an incredibly cool feature because if you set up your capturing software to capture that 120fps, you can get some really cool smooth slow-mo action for your VODs because you have all those extra frames to play with. And lastly, with HD60X, you can pass through 4K 60 HDR and capture 1080p 60 HDR. Now, to get the full breakdown of what HD60X can pass through and capture, be sure to check out our FAQ page that we've linked in the description panel down below. So, HD60X has a lot of power under the hood for a USB 3.0 capture card. But we should talk about how this applies to your use, because each platform you game on has its own caveats. Now, if you play on Nintendo Switch, this console only supports up to 1080p 60 SDR when docked. So, with this system, you won't be taking advantage of the new features that HD60X has to offer compared to our older capture cards. But you will be future-proofing your setup in case you ever add PS5 or Xbox Series X or S to your console collection, or if Nintendo releases a more powerful version of the Switch or releases a newer system. Now, for PS5 owners, this is where the real differences start to show, because PS5 can output 1080p 120, and it can output 4K 60. So with HD60X, you'll be able to enjoy that extra resolution or frame rate while capturing your content. And for Xbox Series X and S, with these systems, you have 4K 60, 1080p 120, and 1440p 120 as output options. So out of all the systems, you have the most flexibility with the Xbox Series X and S when you're using it with HD60X. Now, the only thing I want to mention is there are some Xbox games that will run 120fps on the Xbox Series X, but not the S. And not every game out there will necessarily support 120fps output, period. Now, we've linked a helpful article in the description panel down below, which covers the current releases which support 120fps on the X and S. And lastly, if you're into PC gaming, you basically have every option that HD60X offers at your disposal. Be sure to check out the links in the description panel down below, where again, we cover both the accepted pass-through and capture resolutions of HD60X, as well as up-to-date capabilities of the current generation of systems. Because if you're interested in HDR pass-through or capture, there can be some nuances with what consoles can output in terms of the combination of resolution, frame rate, and HDR, as well as what HD60X is able to take in and capture. HD60X is now available on Elgato.com. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. And don't forget to hit that like button and get subscribed to both our Elgato YouTube channel and our Elgato Workshop channel, so you can catch our latest videos and tutorials to learn how to unlock the full power of your Elgato products. Once again, I'm Steggy from Elgato, and until our next video, good luck and have fun.